Hey guys, this is Abhishek from GadgetReview.com, and today we are going to do the quick unboxing and quick review of Lenovo YZ. Lenovo YZ has been launched in India, and it has been launched for a pretty high price of around 35,999. That is approximately 36,000 rupees for which you can actually buy this device. YZ is actually a successor of YX, which was previously launched in India from Lenovo. That was approximately 5 inch in terms of the overall display size, whereas this device is a phablet and it has been launched at a display size of 5.5 inch. And if we talk about the other device from which it is actually a kind of enhanced or upgraded model, that is the Lenovo K900. Lenovo K900 was available in almost the same kind of packaging which we see on this device as well. So it was similar to this kind of packaging which we have seen on that one. And that device was pretty successful device from Lenovo. And again, although it was not that much pricey as this device is in terms of the price, and that device also saw a price cut when it was launched in India, it was approximately available for around 25,000 to 26,000 Indian rupees, which was fairly good for that device as far as the hardware config is concerned. And Lenovo K900 had the Intel processor inside, whereas this one is Snapdragon 800 chipset which we have on this device. So it is as powerful as your Nexus 5 or any of the devices which are running on the Snapdragon 800 chipset. So here we have the package, and let's unbox the package to actually see what we have in this. Once we unbox it, we have to remove this thing. The model number of this device which we are unboxing is K910L, and this is the same model number which you will get in India. And once you open this box, and again you can see that this is how you can actually read the YZ. And once we unbox this one, the first thing which we get in the package is the device itself, and here we have the Lenovo YZ. This device has got a pretty good display. The front display is 5.5 inch and it is Corning Gorilla Glass 3 protection which we have on the front display. And again, one thing which I really like about this device is the overall form factor. This device being a 5.5 inch display device, which is pretty big in size, you can easily hold this device in one hand because of the slim profile of this device. And again, the build quality is quite commendable which we see on this device. So we will take a look over the device later on. Let's first of all take a look what we have in the package, and then we will discuss about the device. So apart from the device, we get some user manuals which comes within the package over here. So you can open this part and take a look over some of the user manuals which we get in the package. So we have a quick start guide, the important information guide for the product, and then we have the Lenovo limited warranty guide. And apart from this, over here on this box we have got the headphones. So let's take a look over the headphones. The kind of headphones which you get within the package seems to be pretty good in terms of the overall build quality, I would say. And here we have the gold plated headphone jack. And again, if we take a look over the module, this is how the module will look like. And again, this module does not seem to have the volume control. Let me just open it to take a look. Okay, here we have the module inside, the mic module, which has a mic and a button to pick the call. Again, it does not have the volume controls on it, and these headphones are tangled free wired headphones. Looks very good in terms of the build quality, and definitely they should give you good amount of sound, a better quality of sound actually. So this is the headphones. And apart from which, if you take a look over the other set things in the package, here we have got the micro USB cable within the package, and we should also get a charger now. And this is how the charger looks like, and here lies the difference, because this unit is actually imported for our review, so this one does not have the Indian pins over here, whereas the one which will come to India in first week of March or by February end 2014, that will have an Indian pin. And here we have the universal USB wall charger, and the output current from this charger is 1.5 ampere. So it is not a 1 ampere charger, not a 2 ampere, but 1.5 ampere charger which you get within the package. And you also get some earbuds, extra earbuds for the headphones for different ear sizes. And these are all the things which we have in the package. So let's take a look over the device now. Now here we have the Lenovo Vibe Z, and again this device is definitely pretty big to hold in one hand, but again because of the curved edges, and again when we take a look over the back cover which we have on this device, the back cover is non-removable, and again if you take a look, it has got a very nice design, and the overall look and feel of this back cover is kind of metallic in nature. So it looks like that it is actually very good quality of material, metal, but it is actually very good quality of plastic, which this kind of a texture design, which actually gives it a very premium metal like look, but it is not metal. However, when it comes to this part or on the edges, it is completely metal. So over here we see metal, and this is a very good quality of material which they have used. It is actually metal. Over here we see the chrome part, this is again metal, whereas this part over here is actually good quality of plastic. When we take a look over here, we have the 13 megapixel camera with dual LED flash, and you also have a secondary mic for noise cancellation. Here we have the Lenovo branding. On the top we have the power and sleep key, which is a metal button. Over here we have the 3.5mm audio jack. On this side we have the volume rocker, and again I tell you a more functionality of the volume rocker as well. And then at the bottom we have the micro USB port for data syncing and charging. And again when it comes to the secondary mic, the primary mic is over here for voice calling. You have touch capacity buttons which are there within the body of the phone. Over here on the top we have the earpiece, which is a metallic earpiece, and you have the front camera, which is a 5 megapixel camera on this device. And again, one thing I would like to highlight about this phone, because this phone is pretty big in size, and the power and sleep key is actually not at the side, not even on this side, but it is actually at the top. So it might be difficult to reach the power and sleep key at times whenever you are holding the device like this. So in that case, you can actually use the volume rocker on this device, which is actually can be used to actually just press and wake up the device. So you can turn on the display to wake up the device with the help of volume rocker, not the power and sleep key, because power and sleep key is actually at the top. So you can either press the power and sleep key if it is accessible, or if it is not accessible, then you can always press the volume rocker to wake up the device. And once you wake up the device, you can unlock it like this. So this is very good thing, because the power and sleep key is inaccessible at times, so you can use the volume rocker to wake up the device. And when it comes to this side we have the slot for the SIM card, and it will accept a micro SIM, not a normal size SIM card. And again you have a hole over here, and you can remove the SIM ejection tray by inserting a pin inside this hole, so that the tray will come out and you can insert a micro SIM into this device. Again, the battery is non-removable on this device. There is no support for the micro SD memory card. The storage model, which comes for 36,000 rupees in India, is going to be 16 GB, and we will just show you how much of that is actually available. And this is the 16 GB model which we have. As far as the loudspeaker is concerned, the loudspeaker is actually placed at the back on the bottom, as you can see. And again, the placement is pretty okay, and at times whenever you place this device like this, the sound will get muffled a bit, but it will not get blocked because it is actually on the curve, not at the back side. So taking a look over the UI, if you take a look, first of all, let me just show you the lock screen. So once we lock the device, and this is how the lock screen will look like. It gives you the indication of the time and date, and then you can unlock the device like this. You can also launch the camera. Again, the UI which we have on this device is again completely custom UI. You have like 5 home screen as of now. You can have maximum 9 home screen on this device. You also have multi-window supported on this device, which is a kind of a feature in which you can run multiple applications in different screen sizes basically. And again, this is how the UI look like. You have large number of pre-installed applications which are again going to help you to change the look and feel of this device. You can have different kind of gestures which are supported on the device. You have file browser pre-installed. So in terms of the overall UI, the UI is kind of custom UI which is running on top of Android, and it is not slow in terms of the overall operations. Although we do not notice any kind of lag on this device. Okay, so the version of Android which is running on this device is Android 4.3. It is not 4.2.2, so which is good. And the model number of the device is Lenovo K910L. If we take a look over the storage as of now, let me just show you the storage scenario as well. So storage which we have on this device is 16 GB, out of which around 14.34 GB is available to the user. out of which around 2.45 GB out of 16 GB is actually user occupied. And okay, out of 14.34 GB, you get around 2.45 GB, which is OS occupied. So which is occupied by the OS and the custom UI, which is running on this device. And then you have 2.44 GB of apps, which are there on this device. We have installed some applications as well. So again, the total storage is going to be available. That is 4.34 GB on this device out of 16 GB, on which you can install applications, store picture, videos, and other data. And the available storage as of now is going to be approximately 9.17 GB. So approximately 10 to 11 GB you will get once you have this device with you out of the box. So that is going to be the storage which will be available to you. And again, you do not have support for microSD memory card, so you cannot install applications on the microSD memory card. When we talk about the RAM which we have on this device is 2 GB, and out of 2 GB of RAM, as you can see, as of now 815 MB of RAM is being used, whereas you get around 1 GB of RAM which is free. And again, the device is fairly responsive and I do not notice any kind of lag in the UI, either opening different applications at the same time or switching between them. The overall form factor of this device is pretty good. The weight of the device is around 145 grams, which does not make it very heavy as compared to the other tablets which we have in the market of same display size. When we talk about the thickness of the device, is around 7.9 millimeter, which is again fairly thin, I would say, comparing a tablet of this much of display size, and if we compare it with other tablets which are there in the market. So the thickness and the weight is fairly good. When we talk about the resolution, is full high definition on this device, that is 1920x1080, spread over 5.5 inch display. It gives you a pixel density of around 401 pixels per inch. And again, the display is crisp and clear in terms of the overall colors. And as far as viewing angles are concerned, there is no problem. You can see this display from extreme angles without any issues. The viewing angles are pretty wide for this display. And again, the pixelation of the text is not even there. Even if you read a large text document basically on this display, you won't notice the pixelation even if you take a closer look. The front has Corning Gorilla Glass 3 protection, so fingerprints you might notice, especially whenever you turn off the display, you can easily notice the fingerprints, which you can always wipe it off. But when it comes to the scratches, even if you try to scratch the front with a pointed object, it won't get the scratches very easily. So to an extent it will resist the scratches, but again you can scratch it if you actually want to. And again, everything in terms of the overall UI is very much customized on this device. This is how the notification center look like. And again, the notification center also give you different kind of options to actually respond on these notifications. You have all the toggles over here, which can again be accessed, and you can increase the number of toggles you have. You can control over the brightness, data connection, airplane mode you can access, and you can also turn on and turn off the multi-window. Once you turn off the multi-window, the side icon will go back, and once you enable it, it will come. So once you enable the multi-window, you will have this kind of icon, and once you have this kind of icon, you can actually tap on it to start using this multi-window. And once you go through the tour, it will give you the option of opening these applications in small multi-windows, and whenever you tap on it, it will bring up this menu which will give you all the applications which can be run in the multi-window mode. So that you have these applications running in multi-window mode, which are again going to be accessible, and you can move these applications around their window anywhere you want to. You can move them, you can adjust them as per your screen space, and do different things on these devices, these multi-window applications, whenever you have them running in this mode. And again, you can also add more applications into this list. You just need to add over here, and it will actually list all the applications which are installed on your phone, which you can actually run in the multi-window mode. So in case you add an application which is not compatible to run in the multi-window mode, it will say that directly to you, so you will get to know that the application is not supported. Otherwise, it will list all the applications which you have on the device installed, so you can run them in the multi-window if they are compatible to be run in that particular small screen resolution. Now here we have the camera UI, as you can see, and again the camera UI have autofocus as well. It will autofocus on the object which is there in the center, and you do have large number of different modes which you can actually apply. When it comes to different kind of effects you can actually apply, you can have different kind of color effect, magic effect and the lens effect, which is pretty good. The overall camera UI is very much heavily optimized, so you have a large number of options you can actually select from once you take a photo. Apart from which, if we take a look over the settings, we have different modes over here which you can select from. You have panorama mode supported, HDR mode is also there, your super night mode, you also have picture in picture mode as well. So once we go back, we can actually access the picture in picture mode. So in this picture in picture mode, you can actually capture the photo both from the front camera as well as from the rear camera. You can also change this thing to this or to this or to this. So this is how you can actually capture the photo in the dual camera mode in this picture in picture mode, which is supported. And again, this mode was not even supported on Vibex or K900 as well. You also have a buzz shot in which you can take multiple photos at once, and you can take 10 shots maximum in the buzz shot mode. And then you have all these other modes, including the speech mode, the night photo mode, the smile mode, macro mode and time photo mode. So when it comes to the overall settings which you have in the camera UI of this device, it is actually a lot more than you actually see on any other device. When we take a look over the settings, let me just access the settings as well. So when we access the settings over here, when it comes to the resolution at which it is going to take the photos, so the resolution is going to be 10 megapixel and 13 megapixel, you can also select that. And this is how it will take the photo in 13 megapixel resolution, although it will be 4:3 aspect ratio when you have this kind of a resolution set. Otherwise, in 10 megapixel format, it will take a widescreen 16:9 aspect ratio photo. You have the option of controlling the flashlight. You can actually switch to the front camera. So let me just switch to the front camera so that you can have an idea. And this is how the view will look like from the front camera. The front camera is a 5 megapixel camera, and it is pretty good to actually do a high definition video chat. And this is something which is pretty good in terms of the overall video feed, I would say. So the overall video feed looks pretty crisp and clear, and very good in terms of the color reproduction as well. It is very good. That is something I can say. The front camera is definitely very good, and it has face detection as well, especially whenever you are doing video chatting. So that is also a good thing. Let me just go back to the rear camera. So once we go back to the rear camera, this is how it looks like. And when it comes to the settings for the video, let me just show you the setting for the video so that you can see at what resolution does it record the high definition video. So it can record high definition video at 720p or at 1080p. And from the front camera, if we take a look, let me just check the same. So if we go to the front camera and check the settings over there on the video, so the front camera is also capable of recording high definition video at 1080p and 720p, so which is definitely a good thing. You can actually do high definition video recording both from the front camera as well as from the back camera. And again, both of these cameras are fairly different, but again, the quality looks to be really good. So let me just go back just now. Okay, let me just go to the photo mode and go back. Okay, so let me just take a photo of this device so that you can get an idea. And again, we are taking this photo in artificial light in an indoor room, and let's see how does this photo come out to be. So we have just taken this photo, and again, this photo looks really good in terms of the overall color reproduction as well as in terms of the amount of details which I can see. The amount of details as well as the colors are looking very good on this photo. So I would say the camera performance is very decent. And let me just take this photo without artificial light as well so that you can get an idea about the quality of this device when it comes to photos in low light. So let me just take this photo again, and let me just focus over here. And we have just taken this photo, and again, this photo also look very good as compared to the regular object which we have over there, the original object. And this one is also looking pretty good in terms of the amount of details. However, the colors are not that great, but still they are looking very good, especially with this low light photo scenario in which we have taken this photo. It comes to the notification center. You can also customize the notification center with all these settings over here in the custom UI under settings. You also can schedule the power on and power off time for this device. And under location services, you can see that this device does support GPS navigation as well. So once you enable the access to your location and you enable this option of GPS satellite option, you can actually use this device for GPS navigation on the go without any issues. When it comes to some other features, the wallpaper support, if we take a look, it supports live wallpapers, static wallpapers, and you can also run video wallpapers on this device with the help of third-party launchers. When it comes to the custom theme which is running, you can actually change the look and feel of the icons. The overall UI can also be changed to an extent. With all these themes which are already preloaded on this device, you can also install more theme on this device to actually change the look and feel. And right now we have this theme which is currently applied and it is looking good, so we are not going to change that. But again, you do have large number of options when it comes to the themes. When it comes to the audio profiles on this device, these are the audio profiles, and we do not notice any extra settings over here to actually enhance the overall sound quality from this device. When it comes to tethering options, you do have the option of creating a portable Wi-Fi hotspot on this device to share the 3G internet, and that is also possible on this device. When it comes to the features, you have different kind of features which are based on the proximity sensor, like smart call, smart dialer, smart answer, decrease tone volume, pocket mode, in which if it is in there in your pocket, it will automatically increase the ringtone volume so that you can hear it whenever a call is coming. You do have screen lock, so you can actually shake the phone to lock the screen. You also have smart standby in which the screen will light up whenever you look at it. So it will detect your eyes with the help of the front camera. And you do have screen rotation which you can turn on and turn off, and you can also set it to different mode. And then you have white touch, volume key feature, multi-window feature. You also have the option of moving the smart dialer, that is once you have the smart dialer ratio over here, and if you open the phone dialer on this device and smart dialer is enabled, so if you tilt the device like this, it should basically move the dialer to the left or to the right so that you can easily dial a number. In this case, you can actually access all the numbers of the smart dialer keypad quite easily with one hand, and this is a kind of a feature which is suited for one-handed usage. So this is how the messaging application and the phone dialer are actually integrated within the same application. And let me just create a new message. And this is how the keyboard look like. And one thing which we really like about this device is that you do have continuous input supported as far as the keyboard is concerned. The keyboard keys are pretty big in size and quite nicely spaced out from each other, so you will not face any kind of problem while typing on this device, as we did not face any problem. You can always type in the landscape mode as well. And again, the overall messaging UI is kind of optimized, but again not very heavily optimized, so you can easily use this UI without any problem. Now when it comes to the app drawer, this device does not have application drawer. So in case you want to access all the application which you have installed, it will automatically come on the home screen. You have like 4 home screen as of now, and again you can increase them as well. And once you install more application and when the home screen are filled, it will automatically open up a new home screen where you will see the new application which comes pre-installed, so or which you have installed. When it comes to the pre-installed application, let me just give you an idea for the same. You have AccuWeather pre-installed, you have Google Drive pre-installed, you have Cam Scanner which will allow you to scan the documents. You also have Cam Card application which will allow you to scan the business cards and save it. You also have Evernote application company installed, you have Kingsoft Office pre-installed, you have Cleanup application, we will just show you this one, and you also have UC browser which comes pre-installed, which is a free browser. And this device also support wireless display, so you can connect it with a wireless display unit and portrait the display from this device to an external monitor. And if we take a look over the clean monitor, the Cleanup application actually allows you to make your device faster by cleaning up the RAM and freeing the memory which is required to make this device run properly. And whenever you install new application, it will basically show these application before you run them with a new tag, so that you get to know that you have installed some new application. Now taking a look over the system information for this device, the hardware configuration, the model number of the device is Lenovo K910L. You have got ARM V7 processor clocked at 2.2 GHz, which is a quad core processor, Qualcomm MSM8974, which is the Snapdragon 800 chipset. And here we have the resolution. The effective resolution is 1080x1920. And when it comes to the sensors, you have large number of sensors on this device, which include the gyroscope sensor, the orientation sensor. You also have linear acceleration sensor. You have all these calibration sensor, gravity sensor is also there. So when it comes to the sensors, you have really large number of sensors which are actually required on this device. And again, these sensors are going to give you a large number of functionality, and the device will be very good in day-to-day usage, especially with games which actually require these sensors, as well as other applications which actually require these sensors to run properly. Now we are running Temple Run Overhead on this device, which is a casual game. And again, this device has a hardware which can actually support any kind of graphic intensive game as well. This game is very basic for this device, but again, in terms of the overall reflection which we see for the character and the game movements and the overall graphics, the device is very smooth in playing this game. Without any issues, it is actually playing this game. The draw distance for the game is good. The overall response which I am getting from the touchscreen is pretty good, and there is no problem while playing this game. The gravity sensor on the device is also working well. So you can play this game very easily, and you can also play other casual games like Subway Surfer as well on this device. When it comes to heavy graphic intensive game, you can also play Modern Combat 4, Nova 3 and Frontline Commando D-Day as well on this device without any issues. As far as the Neenamax score is concerned, the Neenamax score for this device is almost perfect, which is 60 FPS. And again, you can play any kind of graphic intensive game on this device, including Modern Combat 4, Nova 3, Frontline Commando, D-Day, Subway Surfer, Temple Run Overhead. Any kind of game you can play on this device, provided you have storage for that. And one thing I would like to say is that you have OTG support as well on this device. So once you are running out of storage on this device, especially on the 16GB variant, because this device does not have a micro SD memory card, so you can actually connect an OTG cable and stream the content from a flash drive onto this device. In case you want to watch a movie and that movie is pretty big in size, you don't have to actually transfer that movie onto this device. You can actually have that movie in a flash drive. You connect that with the help of OTG cable with this device and watch it. And again, the OTG cable does not come within the package, and we will just give you a demo of how you can actually use OTG cable with this device. Once you connect an OTG cable like this, in which a flash drive is already connected, you just connect it like this onto this device and it will detect the same. So it will detect the OTG first of all, and once it is detected, you can actually open the file browser to access the contents which is there on this flash drive in the form of videos, in the form of apps, pictures and music as well. And this is very useful feature. And again, one thing I would like to tell you about the multitasking of this device apart from OTG. When it comes to multitasking, if you actually tap and hold over the home key, it will launch Google Now. But in case you want to actually access all the applications which are running in the background, you just need to tap and hold over the setting key. And this is how it will bring up the multitasking menu. Over here in this multitasking menu, in order to kill any application, you just need to slide it upwards. And in case you want to kill all the applications which are running in the background and you would like to free up some amount of RAM, so you can just tap over here and it will automatically kill all the applications, and it will also tell you how much of RAM is actually freed when you kill all these applications. Score which we have got on Antutu benchmark utility for this device is 35408, which is an A+ grade score. And this device has scored very good score as far as the benchmark is concerned, as compared to other devices which are there in the market. And again, this is because of the Snapdragon 800 chipset, which is quite powerful. The overall ranking of this device is above all the other devices, including Samsung Galaxy Note 3 and Sony Xperia Z Ultra. Both of these devices are below this one in terms of the benchmark score, so it has scored highest in terms of the overall benchmark score which you can get on a device like this with this hardware. The score which we have got on Quadrant for this device is again very impressive, and if you actually can read it, I don't know whether you can read it, but I can read it for you. The score is 19952, which is the total score. The score for the CPU for this device is 73546. For memory, it is 17155, and input operation is 6292, 2D is 500 and 3D is 2268. And in terms of the ranking, this device is above all the other devices on Quadrant standard in terms of the ranking, and it has scored much higher as far as the benchmark score is concerned, comparing with other devices which we have over here. On multi-touch, this device supports 10-point multi-touch, which is a good thing. So as you can see, we are right now running a high definition video on this device, and you can get an idea about the viewing angles. The viewing angles on this display are pretty wide. There is no problem while watching this video from extreme angles on this device. You can see what is happening in the video. And let me just increase the volume so that you can get an idea. The overall sound which comes out from the loudspeaker, especially which is there on the back side, is also pretty loud. So the loudspeaker is quite loud on this device, which is something I can say as of now for this device. And the viewing angles for the video watching is also pretty good. Now when it comes to the LED notification light, there is no LED for notifications on this device, so you will not get the LED notification light supported on this device for notification, for missed calls or for messages. Now when it comes to the battery on this device, the battery on this device is a 3000 mAh battery, which will give you around 1 day of backup for moderate usage if you don't watch a lot of videos or if you don't actually play a lot of games on this device. But again, if you do, and if you do play the games for like more than half an hour on this device, then it will not give you that much of battery backup in case of extensive gameplay back or extensive video watching on this device. Apart, if you don't do both of these tasks in high amount in terms of the time for which you are using this device, in that case you will get around 1 day of battery backup. Otherwise you will get around 7 to 8 hours of battery backup with heavy usage. That is something which we have experienced while using this device. So we would like to give a thumbs up to this device as far as the complete value which you get from this device. One thing I would like to say is that the kind of price you actually pay for this device is a little bit higher. Like to say that the build quality of this device is great, the overall form factor of the device is great, the camera on the device is also good. Both the front camera and the rear camera can actually record high definition video. But when it comes to the price you have to pay for it and the storage you get, it is again not that good. So in all, we would like to give a thumbs up to this device. Do let us know if you have any specific question for this device. That's all as far as the quick review is concerned. We will also come up with a detailed review if it is required. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below. You can like this video if this video helped you by clicking the like button below. You can subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.